Hello there, right here we got a brand new pre-release for 1.18. This is pre-release 8, and in this video I'm going to cover all the changes from pre-release 3 all the way up to number 8, and their timestamp for you on the video. But before we get into bug fixes, we're going to talk a little bit about what to expect over the next few days. Coming out on the 30th of November, the very last day of this month, that will be the full release, and we're currently on pre-releases, so that means they're going to come out with release candidates, one towards the end of this week, and probably one at the beginning of the next week. Now even though 1.18 is mostly just the two new cave biomes, there's a lot of cool tricks you could do with these, and I covered all that in this recent video of mine, which you can find on my channel and link below. But it does still seem like the 1.18 is getting kind of rushed, so there might be a 1.18.1 coming after that. Which goes into the next thing I want to talk about, which is bugs. They have been fixing some really major ones, which we'll cover. But if you guys notice anything while playtesting, make sure to report it. And look forward to my video about things you should do before updating. Now, I personally haven't noticed too many annoying bugs in the pre-releases, but let's take a look at a couple that I did. Now, something weird that I did find when updating my testing world here to 1.18 is that this piston will randomly get powered 3 times in a row. It's really strange. This observer is actually getting powered. If you look at the F3 in the right-hand side, it's going to turn from false to true 3 different times. And you assume that means the block is changing somehow. But I don't see any change in the block, so I really don't know what's going on here. It does seem that the block is near a chunk border. But there's like nothing really going on underneath or anything else. Kind of strange. I don't think I have a command block that's placing blocks here or anything. But this pulsing piston did remind me of something. If we go over here where I have my large drip leaf, right here, I have an armor stand and it's constantly activating this drip leaf. And what it does, it puts off 3 signals, exact same timing. So it's almost like the game thinks that this is over there, or it's getting like observers mixed up or something weird. I don't know. But yeah, definitely seems like it's somehow associated with something over here. Now, one bug that really bothers me, and I know it bothers other people, I've seen Hermitcraft members also complain about it, which is this one where you cross different borders. They're actually regions. And yeah, a completely legendary game. I go this direction, it's just fine. I actually walking backwards into the previous chunk, and you can see that huge leg spike occurring in the chart on the left hand side. It apparently has to do with the region files and some block in somewhere. But I really wish they would fix this, because especially with older worlds, it seems like you kind of acquire a bunch of these. I know Hermitcraft has a few of them in spawn chunks that they really don't like. I'll put the link of this bug report in the description if you guys want to upvote it. Now let's take a look at the major changes in these pre-releases. Lava aquifers will now flow downwards into exposed caves underneath them. They resolved the lag issue when opening up chests that had treasure maps inside them. Lighting wasn't updating properly when the world was generating in. They finally resolved this problem where lava was coming out of icebergs. They resolved a problem where updating worlds was causing severe world corruption. There was a problem that rain and snow could sometimes fall on the same block in certain height ranges. Boxes from snowy biomes weren't white, and now they will be once again. Deep Slate was overriding the ore veins, causing them to be much smaller. They also resolved some crashing and lag issues. For the 4th pre-release, they mostly came in and fixed some crashing issues that were quite major, so they did them right away. In the 5th pre-release, they came out with a lot of bug fixes, but the majority of them are just fixes to the textures of different things. The most noticeable one being that the stripped dark oak logs are now darker like the Bedrock Edition. Now these logs' color might not be finalized, as Chai, the person who's working on the texture, now has some new images up on Twitter, where he has the Java old ones on the left and the Bedrock current ones on the right, and in the middle, he's trying to do a compromise where both versions would get this one. Now, I don't work with aesthetic buildings, so textures really don't matter to me. So what do you guys think about this? They also fixed some generation issues in caves, most notably this one where the stalagmites were all the really teeny short ones. And there were some other funny ones like azalea trees placing themselves on top of other trees. They also fixed this trick where you could use an axe to instantly break flowering azalea leaves. N99, my moderator, noticed that breaking blocks with pistons in the east and west directions was causing significant lag, and that has been resolved. Mobs that had water underneath them but had a block between them and the water weren't actually panicking when they were burning on fire. In pre-release number 6, they now changed the way that the game will save. Instead of saving at a specific time, like every 45 seconds, like it used to, the game now saves chunks whenever there is spare time to reduce autosave spikes. For anyone who is part of the speedrunning community, they will know that whenever these autosaves occur, it can really lag their game and kind of cause everything to freeze. Now, it has got better throughout the years, but this also has the consequence of affecting things like when do chunks actually unload. So I'm here in my chunk loading setup where I test how chunks load and unload, and we'll just first uses dropper throw item into the nether, where we have some devices that will explain to us what's going on over there. So in the chat, you can see that it's saying that there are some chunks are entity processing, some are block processing, some are mob cap processing. So everything looks like it's working as it normally does. So let's just see how often it unloads all those chunks. So it just stopped. I'm go ahead and start back up again and also start a timer and see exactly when it stops. It looked like it lasts about 15 seconds. Now this is exactly how it used to work in the past. Throwing item in would just load it for 15 seconds. And also just like 1.17 by loading the nether dimension. And then as soon as it's loaded and if you pause the game at single player, it still doesn't unload the chunks on the other side. You can see once I unpause, they're still active. They also resolved this issue where near the bedrock, on the top of the nether ceiling as well as the bottom, there was a netherrack in some scenarios. Falling blocks like sand that fell and landed at Y0 would immediately break off as items rather than staying as block form. They also resolved a problem where right around the blending area between 1.17 and 1.18 chunks, there would be big areas where the game would just forget to put in new blocks or caves. Now this change to bedrock didn't have any major effect on what happens to bedrock when updated compared to what I've shown before. The only difference is that I noticed that right here there would be like a air block, and now the game just does a better job at filling that in. And also over here there was a lava above it, and the game, since it seemed like that lava is a block, it put in other blocks underneath of that. So far it looks like they aren't going to change anything to do with the bedrock or blocker cave placements going forward. Now if you guys have any particular question that you have about different scenarios when updating your bedrock into 1.18, let me know in the comments so I can cover that in an upcoming video where I'm going to go over things that you should do before updating to 1.18. So make sure you guys are subscribed with the bell notification turned on so you don't miss out on that video. They fixed a problem to do with temperature in old chunks getting changed, causing some mobs that couldn't take the heat, like snow golems, to actually die. There was this bug in the snapshot where if you would climb up a ladder or vine, then if you crouch and you broke it, you'd be left just floating in midair without falling. During updating, people were having the ocean monument spawning guardians outside of the area they used to. Now that's been fixed. In world generation, typically they try to have the bedrock kind of hidden behind other blocks, so the limits of the game aren't so obvious. But in nether generation, it was accidentally exposing large chunks of it. They also fixed some memory leaks as well as crashes. In pre-release 7, they came out with some more fixes, including azalea trees regenerating in deep water, lag was occurring at the world border with a certain render distance, and tweaking it so that when you update from 1.17 to 1.18, your world size doesn't get really large due to a bug. And pre-release 8 is the newest one, which came out today. This includes one about where if you were eating while going through a nether portal, it would create an error. They fix a parity between Java Edition and Bedrock Edition, so now Ravagers will no longer attack baby villagers. Phantoms weren't being scared away by cats, and now they will once again. And they also fixed some crashing bugs. Now head over to my Twitch channel, as I do stream every Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at 2 PM Eastern Time. We'll be answering all your questions about how things will be affected in 1.18 when you update. And thanks everyone who left a follow over at Twitch, as we're getting really close to 40,000 followers. And you can also watch the archive streams if you ever missed the live ones. I'm very excited about 1.18, and I hope you guys are as well. I'd like to thank all you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys over at Twitch. Bye-bye!